So obviously move with Haldane then, keeping with Haldane, and obviously you know, obviously bring somebody in for this. How do you research Haldane for yourself, Bruce, and for Scott?
Well, for me, you know, reading the book, there were other people in the company that I talked to. You know, a lot of it was, got his letters. And then Scott, you did a lot of stuff on your own. And, you know, we gave you materials and, you know, we spoke to people that went to school with him. I can't remember everybody we talked to, but we tried as much as possible on all the characters. You know, some of them was impossible. We just had to guess and, but to try and flesh out who they were and, you know, where they came from and, you know, just to capture the essence of who they are as much as possible beyond the obvious resource of the book.
Yeah. All the material, I mean, Jennifer Jackson, I think, put together, I think she told me all this material, the letters. I mean, it was just, it was so daunting to try and step into those shoes. And they gave me Steve Moore's number, who's Andy's nephew. And yep. I called him up and had a chat with him, which was wonderful. And at the end, I said, geez, you know, these are some big boots to fill. And he said, Andy wouldn't say that. And that just sort of resonated about, okay, so this is the type of guy he is. But the letters that he wrote, didn't get any of the family letters, but letters that he wrote to the dean of Bowdoin. And there's a 15 of those, I think. And he talks, you know, about various sort of what's going on, not specifics, obviously, but things that are going on with the men and other guys that went to Bowdoin. And the last one that he wrote, and he was talking about Peleliu. He said, the next one's going to be a real peach. I'm going to have to remember to keep my head down.